Hello everyone, this is Sir Manoj. Welcome to computer class. Today we'll discuss a new program that is called Circular Prime Number Program. Okay, let's begin the class. A circular prime is a prime number with the property that the number generated at each intermediate step when cyclically permitting its digits will be prime. For example, 1193 is a circular prime since 1931, 9311 and 3119 are also prime numbers. So you can say that 1193 is a circular prime. Okay. Now let's see the figure. Here the number is 1193. After rotating is coming 1931, then 9311, then 3119. So here the original number as well as the rotation number all are prime. You can say this is a circular prime number. Let's start the program. So here is the circular prime number program. What is circular prime? I had already told you. Now this is the program. So let's begin the program. Package name given. Then the main method. Now see, lots of variables I have taken. Num C1 equals 0, that is for counter. C2 also a counter. R, N, I, N, double N. K equals to 0, P equals to 1, X equals 0. Why I have taken, I will tell you throughout the program. Then declare the scanner class. Enter a number. That number will store in num. And num will store in N. Okay, now I have taken a while loop. This loop I have taken to count the number of digits present in the number. So if I will take 73, then next 2 will store. Okay, so this while loop over. After that I have taken a for loop. For I equals to 1, I less than equals to num I plus plus. This loop I have taken to check whether the entered number is prime or not. So what is prime number? If the number has is 2 factor, it is said to be a prime number. So C1 plus plus is the counter. So the loop will continue. Okay, so if it is a prime, in C1 2 will store. Now see, if the given number is prime, then it will enter ifs block. It means it will enter to this block. If this is false, direct it will go to else part. This else part, it will display not a prime number. Understand? So now go back to the if block. Okay, so here is the if loop. So if the number is a prime number, then it will enter to this ifs block. N equals num. Say the number is 1193. Next the while loop will begin. While p less than equals to x. So p is a counter. I have initialized as 1 at the very beginning. And x is the number of digits. So this loop will continue. The number of digits time the loop will continue. If the number is 73, it means the number of digits is 2. So this loop will continue 2 times. If the number is 1193, it means the number of digits are 4. So this while loop will continue 4 times. Understand? Now see, after the while loop, I have taken r equals to n mod int math.pow 10, x minus 1. Okay, so the number is 1193. Understand? So r equals to 1193 mod x minus 1 given. So 1193 means x means how many digits? 4. So in x 4 will store. So 10 to the power x minus 1 means 10 to the power 3. It means 1193 mod 1000. So in r what will store? The remainder. So what is the remainder? 1193 if you divide by 1000, the remainder will come 193. So in r 193 will store. Understand? So in r what will store? 193. Now next n is given. N equals to n slash means what? Quotient. again mat dot power 10 comma x minus 1. So n equals to n by 10 to the power 3. So this is the remainder and this is the quotient. So this will store in R and this will store in n. So in n 1 will store, understand? So I have separated. So in R 193 will store and in n 1 will store. Now next, nn means new number equals to R into 10 plus n. Now tell me R how much is there? 193. So 193 into 10 plus 1, so it is 1930 plus 1, so 1931. So I have taken the number 1193. Okay, so the circular first it will come 1931, yes or no? Now see, 1931 came. Now we have to check this number is prime or not. Okay, let's go back to the program. So if the number is prime, then it will come to while part. R over n over new number, it will store the new rotation number each time. For example, first it will store 1931. Okay, now we have to check that 1931 is a prime or not. So this is the prime logic. For loop I have taken C2. So if C2 is the second counter, if this is 2, then in K 1 will store. If the new number is prime, then in K it will store 1, otherwise it will break. Clear? Okay. If the new number is not prime, it will break. If it is a prime, it will come to C2 equals 0. Again the counter to initialize 0. Now in N, again the new number will store, P will increase. Okay, now again it will go to the loop. Second time the loop will start. Here. Now P will be 2. So again this repetition will continue. How many times? 4 times. Okay. Then at last, if K equals to 1, it is a circular prime, else it is not circular prime. Understand? So this is the program to check whether the number is a circular prime or not. Okay, now I will compile the program. No syntax error, close, right click, void main. Okay, so suppose I'll enter 1193. Yes, it's a circular prime. Let's take another number, say 73. So if you 73, see the number is 73. So 73 is a prime number. If you loaded 37, so 13 also prime number. So we'll see it's a circular prime or not. So the number is, I will enter now, 73. Yes, it's a circular prime. Understand? Now I will enter another number, say 14. So what it will show? 14 is not a prime number. Clear? So if the number is prime, then it will go inside the if block and check it is circular prime or not. If the number is not a prime number, that it will show. Okay, let's take another example. Say 97, circular prime. Understand? Now another example. So just try to understand. 113, circular prime. So which one is not a circular prime? That also we have to check, yes or no. So if you will take 19, tell me what it will display. Not a circular prime. Why? Because 19 is a prime number. If you will reverse, it is coming 91. So 19 is not a prime number. That is a not a circular prime. Okay. Now let's see the full program and practice circular prime. Comments no need to write, just write the program and practice it 2 to 3 times. Okay.